Welcome from Munich to This Is My Architecture. Today my guest is Steffen from EMnify. Welcome, Steffen.
Hi, Thomas.
So, Steffen, I'm curious, what are you holding in your hand? Is EMnify in the movie business?
No, actually not. EMnify is an API-driven mobile network allowing customers to reliably connect their devices anywhere in the world using cellular connectivity.
Okay, cool. So I see here an e-scooter. So if I would operate a platform of e-scooters, how would I make use of the EMnify platform?
Yeah, first of all, you probably would get such a reel of SIM cards in the form of very tiny chips that you would solder into this device.
Okay.
So our customers, they have their e-scooter with a cellular modem and an EMnify SIM card. And they also operate their backend application. And in this example, the e-scooter would regularly want to report its battery level and its coordinate. And the customer application would, for example, want to unlock this e-scooter when an end customer wants to use it.
Okay, Steffen. Let's go a little bit deeper into your architecture. So looking here at the architecture, it looks like you're doing quite a lot of heavy lifting. So what actually needs to happen that the e-scooter can communicate with the backend?
Yeah, first it needs to establish a connection through the mobile network. So it communicates with the visited operator, and this is then sending a request into our platform. But before this request can reach our deployment on AWS, we first need a connectivity to all of these operators worldwide. So we have a roaming with more than 540 operators in more than 180 countries.
Wow, that's quite impressive.
And the network that interconnects all of these operators is the so-called IP exchange, okay, which is a global private network just for cellular roaming traffic. And we are connected using multiple carriers via direct connect to have reliable connectivity in all of the regions where we are deploying this packet gateway architecture.
Okay.
So the request, when it then reaches our VPC, is first received via UDP network load balancer.
Okay.
And from there, it's forwarded into our control plane application, which receives this create session request.
Okay.
And this is part of the GTP protocol, which is used in mobile networks.
Okay. So actually, what needs to happen that the scooter gets a response, and what's in that response, actually?
Yeah, what our platform then does, it looks up the configuration of this SIM card, which features should be enabled, which security configuration has the customer defined previously.
Mm-hmm.
Our customers are then able to configure these security features using the API gateway and our portal, but they also integrate our platform into their applications for automated device provisioning and configuration and monitoring purposes.
Makes sense.
So when we have this configuration read from the database, first of all, our control plane application here sends some of that information down to our user plane, which later handles all the IP traffic. And other parts of the systems are sent back as a response to this request to the mobile network, and that includes information like, for example, the IP address that is then used for the scooter.
So there's happening quite a lot for just establishing that connection.
Exactly, but it's then ready, really, to send data.
Okay, so now, is the scooter ready to communicate with the backend?
Yes, with all that information available, there is basically a tunnel established from the visited network to our network, and through this, the data can flow.
Okay, so are there any restrictions on protocols you can use to communicate with the backend? So like MQTT or HTTP or whatever?
Yeah, it's up to our customer which do the implementation, and yes, it could be HTTP, but in the IoT use cases, something better fitting like MQTT, as you said, for example, with a broker in AWS IoT would definitely make sense.
Okay, cool.
And this data is then sent into this tunnel from the device and then reaches our packet gateway application, which does the accounting, firewall, and other security features. And then it's usually then sent to our customer running on AWS via transit gateway or in their on-prem servers. And to allow high throughput use cases, we're using a specialized framework for high-speed packet processing here in this cluster of EC2 instances.
Wow, amazing. So what overall makes this architecture special?
Well, first of all, that it runs on AWS. This is a telco system, and it's very nice to be able to use a standard network load balancer. In other parts of the system, we have developed our own load balancers just to handle the telco protocols. Apart from that, it's very nice that we are, since already 2016, running customer workloads in our cloud-native mobile network, whereas the rest of the telco industry just now slowly with 5G is migrating into software-based architectures and running those things in the cloud. So we are a couple of years ahead.
Awesome. That sounds amazing. Steffen, thanks for giving us insight into your architecture, and thanks for being my guest.
Thanks for the invitation.
And thanks for watching This Is My Architecture.